Welcome to the 2018 Borderless Arts Tennessee Young Soloist Competition. I have Cole from MTSU Organizational Communications 3250 class. And this is a project we helped coordinate alongside Borderless Arts Tennessee with assistance from the student organization, the Ambassadors of Borderless Arts Tennessee. Before we begin, I wish to thank our sponsors, First Tennessee Bank, Congressman Diane and Dr. David Black, and the MTSU ESL program. Please note that our class is also raising funds for this program to help pay for the costs of offering mentoring sessions, paid performances, and a day professional development training this summer for you participants. If you would like to donate to this program, please see me or any of my classmates after the program. Also, thank you to Tim Musselman and the music department for allowing us to host the event here. Ray Kuhn for his video work, and Andrea Baker for her sign interpretation. Please note that we will present a fan favorite award tonight based on the performer who receives the most audience response. This award will be determined by some MTSU students who've been positioned in various places in the audience and backstage. Before I introduce our host for the evening, we have an opening act of an MTSU student singer-songwriter who has used her music to help raise funds for the Young Soloist competition and has performed for numerous other Borderless Arts events. Please help me in welcoming Samantha Campbell.
Thank you.
accomplished singer-songwriter who has numerous CDs that have spanned over a 30-year career of touring. She is now serving her fifth term as a state representative for House District 40. Add to her role as a wife, mother, and grandmother, she finds solace in residing with her husband on their restored historic farm in Lancaster, Tennessee. Please help me in welcoming Representative Terry Lynn Weaver.
Thank you. Good evening. How's everyone tonight? Look at the person next to you and say, hot diggity dog, God did a good thing when he made you. Just say it. Grandmother, it happens. All right. Are you all excited for the wonderful talent you're going to hear here tonight? Isn't this amazing? You're going to have a fun time. Indeed. It is a great pleasure to recognize the outstanding talents and accomplishments of these young musicians that have come from all regions of Tennessee. Now, tonight you are going to see the finalists that made it through the first round of competition. Special thanks to the judges. Our first performer tonight is Vanessa Cox. Now, Vanessa was singing before she even learned how to speak. That's pretty cool. Her love for singing became known around the age of 3 when she began to sing songs such as Jesus Loves Me and The Windows of Heaven in front of the entire congregation every Sunday morning. As she has grown older, Vanessa has realized that God has blessed her beyond measure with her voice, and has provided several opportunities for her to share this gift with others. That's why we have gifts, right? We have gifts to share them with others. Go, Okay, to make sure you're still with me out there. She has recently became known for singing the national anthem. Vanessa has sang the national anthem at her high school basketball games, minor league baseball games, and even Bristol Motor Speedway. Although she is very thankful that you want to hear her story, she prays that you will only hear God's story through her music. She says that her identity is found in Christ, and without him, she would not be standing in front of you today. Here's Vanessa singing Oceans by Hillsong United. Please welcome Vanessa Cox.
Oh, yeah, born water,
Thank you, Vanessa. Our next performer is Anthony Bonini. Unfortunately, Anthony cannot be here tonight due to the flu. Austin Anthony, a 17-year-old junior at Overton High School for the Creative and Performing Arts, began singing in the school choir at Kate Bond Middle School in Memphis when he was in sixth grade. He traveled with the choir in seventh grade to Disney World in Orlando, where the choir placed first in the national competition. Last school year, Austin played Ernie in Overton School's musical Sister Act. Besides singing and acting, Austin also has a passion for doing voiceovers. Last year, Austin was delighted to be awarded the Fan Favorite Award here at the Young Soloist competition, and he is so excited to be back again this year. His hopes for the future definitely includes being on stage. Austin will actually be singing I'm Still Standing instead of Home. So please help me welcome him.
Song for you, something that I wrote many years ago. 30 years on the road before I knew what I'm doing today. We traveled all over the country and homeschooled my children. My son actually now plays guitar for some of the big wigs in Nashville, but he learned everything from his mother. But anyway, we were out in the middle of nowhere in Colorado, and my husband was off bow hunting. And he said, I'm going to leave for the morning, and you keep camp, keep the fires going. So I had my Bible and my guitar and a beautiful scenery in front of me. Miles and miles of mountaintops. So guess what this song is called? You are right and very smart. So the next mountaintop goes like this. Remember the words. I'm a long, long way from Baltimore County and the hills I used to roam. I dream about the way.
Thank you.
Sarah Franklin. Sarah has a passion for music for as long as she can remember. At 2 years old, she began singing and dancing with family and began performing at 8. Sarah has been successful in her church choirs and now is a lead singer in her church praise band. She loves helping other people of all ages and abilities by sharing the music she writes, sings, and plays. Sarah's primary song of choice today reflects the personal hardship she has experienced in life and the motivation that music provided to find inner strength and work through it all. Here's Sarah Franklin singing an acoustic version of Demons by Imagine Dragons.
She has also been a member of the Nashville Children's Choir for 5 years, sung with her church choir for 3 years, and appeared in various theatrical productions. Musical theater has always been her first love, which is why she has chosen to perform Think of Me from Phantom of the Opera, the longest-running musical on Broadway. Please make welcome Miss Mary Maggie Perry.
Discovered a keyboard and has been known ever since for his exceptional improvisational skills in diverse musical styles. Elliot is the winner of the 2017 BSA International Young Soloist Competition and Jean Kennedy Smith Arts and Disability Program, recognizing outstanding musicians with disabilities ages 14 to 25 from around the world. Award we accumulated with a performance at the Kennedy Center Millennium Stage in Washington, D.C. As a freshman at Belmont University, Elliot was selected as a pianist for the premier jazz ensemble at the university. He was honored to have a feature role, sharing a duet with Ricky Skaggs when Mr. Skaggs was awarded the prestigious Applaud Award at the 2014 President's Concert. He was one of several featured soloists with the jazz band during the nationally televised Christmas at Belmont performance in 2013. And performed in the Woods Piano Scholar Concert at Sheepwood Arts Department. Prior to college, Elliot performed with Lake Rise Place, LRP, a local pop trio as keyboardist and lead vocalist in numerous local events and venues from 2008 to 2012. With LRP, he performed at prestigious venues including the Schermerhorn Symphony Center, the Ryman Auditorium, Tennessee Performing Arts Center, and the Ford Theater at the Country Music Hall of Fame Museum. Many of the events were sponsored by Borderless Arts Tennessee. Elliot was awarded the Woods Piano Scholarship by Belmont University School of Music, a four-year scholarship awarded annually to one freshman entering Belmont as a music major, as a piano major, for that. The Mayor's Advisory Committee for People with Disabilities named Lake Rise Place Artist of the Year in 2011. They were named the Tennessee Goodwill Ambassadors by Governor Phil Brinson in 2010. Elliot has a Bachelor of Music degree in Commercial Music from Belmont University and is currently pursuing a Master's in Music. We are pleased to have with us tonight Mr. Elliot McLean.
Thank you. Billy Joel, and it was one of the pieces that I performed when I had the honor of being selected as the BSA, one of the BSA National Young Soloists, and having that opportunity to perform at the Kennedy Center and to meet so many great people in Washington, D.C. was a great experience. This last piece I'm going to do for you is also one that I performed at the Kennedy Center. It was written by Eddie Arnold and Cindy Walker. Did very well as a country tune, and then Ray Charles had hit with it later on and introduced it to a whole new audience. Hope you enjoy it. This is called You Don't Know Me.
Thank you. Lori Kissinger. I'm the director of Borderless Arts Tennessee and also the instructor for your group 3250 class. And before we call out the winners, I needed to make a couple of acknowledgments. Representative Weaver not only came this evening and is assisting, but she's been involved with our program since 2013. She comes to programs, she has donated dulcimer, she's become a very good friend. And I wanted to recognize her, Representative Weaver, if you would come out here for a moment. Stand, and those of you backstage, hey, backstage Orco 3250 students, come on out here. So early on, we are told, I tell the class that with the event planning, one of the first things that they need to learn is flexibility. And boy, did this class get that. I have never had a class who's gone through as much adversity as this class. We had a crunched time frame to begin with, then we were faced with weather, which crunched us even more. Then we were faced with potential weather tonight, which we were going around with. Then we were faced with flu, which took out one of our performers tonight and our co-host. So what you don't know is that Nicole, who I know I've got some speech students out there who are scared giving public speeches. Well, Nicole was just supposed to welcome all of you tonight. Instead, she got handed a script and said, guess what? You're a co-host. Besides for that, I ended up having an emergency the day that we were supposed to do the run-through. And so our leader of the class project, I had to call her and say, I can't be there. Guess what? You're in charge. So this class has made it through all of it. They've done an amazing job, and I just wanted to say thank you to them, and please give them a round of applause. I wanted to represent the class coordinator who had to take it upon herself to be a teacher for a day, and she kept it in check, and I'm very proud of her. Come on up here, don't worry. Back over to your host.
We are now at the time that many of you have been anticipating, the announcement of the winners. Last year, we initiated a fan favorite award. This award is based on the participant that received the most audience response throughout the evening and is determined by select MTSU students that have been stationed in the audience and backstage. So the fan favorite award goes to Drew.
I just want to make a quick thank you to all the friends and family who is very, very, very special. I just wanted to know, well, thank you for my friends from Family Christian Academy and all my friends and all my family and my grandparents out there. I just want to say thank you so much and have a good night.
Second place. winner is Vanessa Cox.
Thank you.
time tonight. Yeah. It was awesome. I had a blast. I was back in the back making all the woo-hoo noises. That was Edie back there doing her thing. Our final thanks go to all of you for coming out tonight. I really appreciate, we appreciate you making the endeavor to come out. It's cold, and we still have snow now, but we appreciate you coming out because it's important to have an audience for these kids. And I pray that you will continue to encourage them in their gifts as they continue to share their gifts, because this was a great time tonight. We also want to thank the judges and, of course, the sponsors, our First Tennessee Bank, Congressman Diane and Dr. David Black, and the MTSU Excel program. And please remember, if you would like to donate to this program, as you can see, the fruits of its labor, this is the arts, this is music, this is awesome, this is so in the lives of these kids. Please, we'll gladly pass the hats. You can leave your love offering back there by the door. So drive safely tonight and have a great night. I'm going to thank the sound crew, all the volunteers. There's lots of people to thank. It takes a whole crew to do something like this tonight. Most of all, we thank you for coming. Drive safely and God bless. Good night.